Good afternoon. As everybody would be aware, over the last few days, we've been investigating a number of break-ins that have occurred on business premises throughout the metropolitan area. As a result of our investigations to date, I can inform you that we've arrested three youths in relation to some of those offences. The first one is a 14-year-old who had been charged with four counts of serious criminal trespass that relates to the business break-ins at Greenwith, at the Findon supermarket and the pizza bar at Torrensville. The second one is a 15-year-old boy is arrested and charged with serious criminal trespass on the coffee shop at Torrensville, breach of bail and also for an outstanding warrant. And the third person arrested is a 14-year-old boy, male, charged with two counts of serious criminal trespass on the coffee shop and the pizza bar, and also being unlawfully on premises. All three of these people have been refused police bail and will appear in the Adelaide Youth Court later today. I just want to add to those arrests. We are currently investigating several lines of inquiry. Our Mandrake Task Force, supported with other resources from both the southern, eastern and northern districts, are conducting significant investigations into other people who may be or who are involved. I can inform you that the identities of several of these people that remain outstanding are known to police. And I would ask for those that know of these people, I'm talking particularly of other friends, associates and family members, to encourage them to contact us so that you know, we can speak to them relative to their involvement in these particular matters. This is, you know, the level of offending continues to be of a significant concern to the community and to us. The amount of damage, the impact on people's lives and businesses is significant. And often it's for very little gain for those people committing these offences. So we are doing everything we possibly can, working with the community, working with the families of some of the people involved in these matters, to bring this to a speedy and swift conclusion. I'm happy to take any questions.
How many other suspects are you looking for?
I won't go into precise numbers as to how many others are involved. As I say, it's a fairly dynamic investigation, and as a result of that, you know, those sort of numbers change as we rule people in and rule people out. I can tell you there'd be five or so more at the very least.
There was another break-in overnight out of Golden Grove, a smash and grab where a 40-year-old man was arrested. Is that unrelated to this crime series you're all talking about?
It is unrelated, but I must say, with all the events occurring over the last 24-48 hours, we're closely examining every single one of those offences just to see if there are any links between them. So all of them are being grouped together, but I can tell you on that particular one, no, we don't think it is related.
You mentioned one youth was in breach of their bail. Are there tough enough penalties for youths?
Absolutely. We worked very hard on putting a lot of detail before the courts, you know, in relation to repeat offenders or those people that offend. We looked at a control their behaviour by putting bail conditions on people to stop them from reoffending or to stop them associating with others. We think that there's a very strong link where people get together and certain members of the group influence residents, others. So bail conditions are used very effectively for us, and we will look to enforce those bail conditions at every opportunity we possibly can.
Are these other five outstanding people potentially youths or mixed ages?
Mixed ages at this point in time, but they would be in the majority under 18 years of age.
And you know who they are?
We have a very good indication as to who they are, and we've spent a lot of time over the last 24 hours or so speaking to community members, associates and the like, as to their whereabouts. So the community would know too that we are looking for these people specifically.
If by chance they are watching, what's your appeal to them?
My appeal to them is quite simply, we need to speak to you. You know, as we know, some of these people are involved in smashing the grabs. These people are involved in stealing cars. Some of those occurrences where cars are stolen and the like creates a significant risk not only to themselves but also a significant risk to other community members. We would ask that they hand themselves in, speak to their family, hand themselves in so that we can resolve these things as safely as we possibly can.
Great, thank you.